Let's practice using the second derivative test. So here are the directions for this problem. Locate the critical points of the following function, then use a second derivative test to determine whether they are local maxima, local minima, or neither. And our function is f of x equals 3x cubed plus 4.5x squared plus 7. So actually this is a function we've already worked with several times during this lesson. We've already found its first derivative and its critical points. So to save a little time, I'm going to go ahead and just transfer that information here. And then we'll just practice using the second derivative test. So this is what we had before. The derivative was 9x squared plus 9x, and then there were no places that didn't exist. So the critical points came from the places where the derivative equals 0, which we found to be x equals 0 and x equals 1. Okay, so we have the first step already. We've located the critical points. But now we want to use the second derivative to determine whether these are local maxima, minima, or neither. So what does the second derivative test tell us? So basically in the second derivative test, you're using the second derivative, of course, to test whether a point is a maximum or minimum. And the way you do that is by evaluating the second derivative at the point in question. So if the second derivative is positive at that point, then the critical point is a local minimum. If the second derivative is negative, then the critical point is a local maximum. And the second derivative is zero at that point, then the test isn't conclusive. Okay, so let me tell you why that makes sense. So let's start working through this. So first of all, okay, so now we're actually doing the second derivative test. Okay, so we, of course, have to start by taking the second derivative. So if I do that for my function, I'm going to get 18x plus 9. All right, so what the second derivative test tells us is to evaluate the second derivative at the critical points. So let me start with x equals 0. I want to evaluate f double prime of 0. So I'm just plugging in 0 to my function, and I get 9. Now the important thing here isn't actually the value 9, it's whether it's positive or negative. Okay, so here it's positive, right? So f double prime of 0 is positive. Okay, so why does that matter? What does that tell us? So if you think back into the last section where we learned about concavity, remember the second derivative tells us about concavity. And the second derivative being positive tells us that at this point, x equals 0, the graph is concave up. Okay, so graph is concave up at x equals 0. So something like this. So if the graph is concave up there, and x equals 0 is a critical point, then x equals 0 must be a local minimum, right? And you can kind of just picture that from this little illustration I drew. So that's kind of why the second derivative test makes sense. Okay, so this tells us then that f of 0 is a local minimum. And of course, you could actually calculate what f of 0 is, but the problem doesn't actually ask us to do that. It just says to determine whether they are local maxima, local minima, or neither. So f equals 0 is a local minimum. All right, so let's do the other point, negative 1. So once again, same process. Now we're evaluating f double prime of negative 1, but I'm just plugging that into the second derivative. So 18 times negative 1 plus 9 is negative 18 plus 9, which is negative 9. Okay, so f double prime of negative 1 is negative. Okay, so kind of using the same logic, this tells me that the graph is concave down at x equals negative 1. So it looks something like this time. And x equals negative 1 is a critical point, so now I can reason that that must be a local maximum. Okay, so f of negative 1 is a local maximum. Okay, so in this example, we saw the second derivative being positive and negative. Now, you could also have a situation where you plug in your critical point and you get that the second derivative equals 0. In that case, the test is inconclusive. The critical point could be a local max, local min, or neither. So if you had to determine which it was, then you would have to use the first derivative test instead. But when it works, the second derivative test is a pretty quick way to check if something is a local max or min.